Hello guys, today's video is an important video, so do watch it till the end and do let me know how it went for you. Let's start.
This is GS paper 3 and we are talking about technology, economic development, biodiversity, environment, security and disaster management, of which for now we'll be looking over economic development. So one thing that you need to see is that when we say economics, it's not just economics, it's something developing of the economics. So just don't care about ki they'll be asking you about GDP or something like that, because this is not just the basics of economies, this is economic development. Then you have biodiversity, which is different from environment. So when we say environment, it does not include biodiversity, your IUCN status, your threatened species and where are they found and what are the parks, what are the conservations, what are the reserves for them. All of these fall under biodiversity and not environment. So that's a different portion. It involves a different weightage. So right now we have to see up here, because after that is science and technology, which we are not focusing right now. We are right now focusing on economics. We'll see what all do we have to study and from that what are we studying currently. See, first of all, we have to know about Indian economy. So the history, the geography, the biography, everything of India, everything of its economy, the 5-year plans that you had and what was the economic status before that. So when there's a question on that, what was the economic status of the Indian society, the Indian economy from the colonial period. So that is a part of history, but that also falls under Indian economy. Then we have the issues related to the planning, the mobilization of resources, the growth, development and employment. So employment is a different topic here. Planning is different, mobilization of resources is different, growth and development both are different. So what is growth, what is development, what is the difference between growth and development? We all need to see all of this. Then we have inclusive growth and issues arising from it. So what is inclusive growth, its advantages, its disadvantages, challenges, implementation, strategy, and what are the issues arising from it and how can they be subsided, what could be the possible outcomes and everything. Then the government budgeting, of what all is the government focusing on in its budget, what is the deficit financing that they are following and why is it that way, and what all the, so the economic survey that you talk of, this covers our government budgeting. Then we have major crops, their cropping patterns, and then different types of irrigation, the irrigation system, storage, transport, marketing of agricultural produce, and related constraints, technology, aid of farmers. So farmers, you see here, this is a part of your Indian society. Peasants are a part in your Indian history. Then you have the aid of farmers here. Then you have, when you talk about the social welfare schemes and everything, farmers are there. So farmers is important, agricultural produce is important, because India's outcome, the population of India, most of them are heavily dependent on agriculture. So this is one important part that you need to see. There is storage, there is transport, there is irrigation system. So all of this is important, and when we'll study major crops, we link it with geography, because in geography also there are crops, there is a syllabus of crops that would be beneficial to us when we read both of them together, so that we have an analytical view to both their sides. Then what do we have? We have issues related to direct and indirect farm subsidies. So this is a separate topic. Minimum support prices is a separate topic. So it's not just about, you have to know about what is minimum support prices, you have to know about everything, what are its challenges, how are they implemented, when were they implemented, what was the initial status, what is currently going on, what are the issues arising from it. Then we have public distribution system, which is very, very important, because right now, in fact, with public distribution system, they have also started integrated public distribution system, or it's IMPDS, something like that, and I forgot about that. Anyway, so like that, we have objectives, functioning, limitations, revamping, issues of buffer stocks, food security, technology, economics of animal rearing, and then see technologies here, technologies, e-technology here, and everywhere you'll find that apart from just the science and technology, you have to use technology in every place, and you have to link technology. You cannot just think about, chalo, we'll not look into technology right now, because this is a segregate subject. So we'll do when we are doing that. Whatever comes in your plate, you need to see whether you'll be able to eat that or not, or whether you should be eating that or not. Then we have food processing. C see, this is one topic which we entered now, but before that only so many things about food we've already seen, about the food security, about your buffer stocks, about how are they distributed, about integrated farm subsidies and everything, and storage and all. And here is food processing related industries in India, food processing scope, its significance, its location, its upstream and downstream requirements, supply chain management. And this supply chain management and inclusive growth is, I think, very important, because any last year paper that I've seen, I've found some question from here or here somehow manipulated way in a good direct way or indirect way there in the paper. Then we have land reforms in India, which is good, important, because you know, it was that era where the revenue was earned from land, where land was everything for people. Just like today, water is everything for people, and there are so many disputes relating to water. Then we have effects of liberalization on the economy, the changes in industrial policy, effects on industrial growth. So you have to talk about the 1991 thing, you have to know about everything about that, and what was initial status of India, what is status now, and how we are now moving into the privatization part, how the, you know, the privatization of railways, you can talk of everything. So you need to grasp everything that's coming there. Then we have infrastructure, energy, ports, roads, airports, railways, etc. And I think with this you need to do, because why, see, just with infrastructure, railways, there was a question, the privatization of railways, what are your viewpoints about it or something like that. So what is happening is, see, it's just an Indian economy portion that you had to look into. Now, can which economics has railways in it? I don't understand. But then, and even if they have railways, they can have railways from the GDP sector point for anything like that way. So this is not just economics, it is economic development, developing of a country economically, and railways is a part. Why? Because infrastructure is a part. How is infrastructure a part? Because once you have infrastructure, you have a better standard of living. Once you have better standard of living, you have employment for people, and once you have employment for people, you have indirectly a better GDP growth in your country. So that is economic development. So we need to focus on all of this, and we'll go through once we actually start finishing economic development. And then we have the investment models, the ways people are investing, the ways the government is investing, and all the schemes that you have. Today only I was going through, I think, Jan Dhan Arogya Yojana. So there is also, like, government is investing inside there. There was also animal husbandry fund that has been created. I'm sorry if I'm wrong, but then something like that has been created. So these are things that you can use in investment models here. These are things that you can go through and know about what all are here. This is the complete portion, the analysis of economic development, which is very, very important. See, guys, even if you don't know everything from it, it's not that important. What is important is that you know that, yes, this is existing. What is important is you at least don't have a guilt inside you that you studied, but you studied something that wasn't even necessary, or that wasn't even vital, or that wasn't even required. So the best would be that even if you're studying less, even if you're giving it lesser of your time, it's fine. But the point is that you give the major portion, the chunk out, and see, like, inclusive growth is a topic which have had questions in all the years. I've seen it in 2013, in 14, in 16, in 17, in 18, in 19 again, and 20 is yet to go. I mean, the paper analysis. Yeah. So that way, inclusive growth is important, food processing is important, and land reforms, like, see, it's just a topic here, land reforms. And even in the question paper, it was just one question that was there in land reform in all these years that I saw. But land reform is important. Why? Because you can use that land reform in other places where you want to put in your answer, or you want to enhance your answer. So you cannot leave out, you cannot chunk out, because if you leave out land reforms and there's a question of 15 marks or 10 marks, you're gone, because that 1 mark, that half a mark is very, very important. So this is it with today's video. I hope you liked it. Do comment down which is the portion that is still left of yours, or did this video in any way help you, or gave you a better view or a better analytical concept towards the studying UPSC syllabus, or studying about the UPSC, or anything like that. Do let me know, guys. Your reviews do matter. Thank you.